sure do whatever people want to celebrate. Now I've heard the story of Jesus. I think it's alright if you believe. But as for me, I'm gonna be PC. I think most people would agree with me that it's just another holiday.
What do you say?
It's just another holiday.
Jesus has for me.
We really need it.
I'm the
shoes on, Tess. Vacation price. Most of my hotels stay pre-booked up most of the time.
That's okay, Mom. That's a good problem to have.
So, Mr. Teller, do you really hate Christmas?
Well, I don't hate it. I guess it really just doesn't mean that much to me.
Why's that?
Well, as far as business goes, it's fine. The hotel's always really low this time of year. On the personal side, I grew up in an orphanage, and Christmas always made me feel really sad that I didn't have a family. People would always come to the orphanage to look kids to adopt, but no one ever really seemed to have room for me. When I got older, I just decided to work hard and stay busy, not think about the past or painful things like the Christmas holidays. So I got a job at a hotel, worked my way up the ladder, and now I own the whole chain. Life's pretty good. It's funny, though. Kind of ironic. I groom some people all the time now, and no one's ever really seemed to have one for me.
So, have you ever heard about the real meaning of Christmas? About Jesus' birth?
Bits and pieces. Occasionally, people would come to the orphanage and look for do special programs, but I never really paid much attention.
Well, we could tell you about it. It's an amazing story. It's about a plan that God had for us, a plan to send his son to the earth so that we could know real life is all about. I know you grew up thinking that no one loved you and that no one had room for you, but God loves you. He always has. He made you, know, and he has a plan for your life. And that plan led you here tonight. To hear the truth, he brought you to a show called Christmas Crosstalk.
In your business, you know that the value of something is determined by how much someone is willing to pay for it. We need to know that God paid the highest price for you and for all of us when he sent Jesus into the world. He knew that it would take a miracle for us to truly understand what his love for us is all about. So he sent Jesus to be that miracle.
That's right, Mo. God brought you here tonight to hear the truth. He brought you to a show called Christmas Crosstalk. The truth is even in the title. The story begins with the Christmas story of Jesus' birth. Goes on through his death on the cross and his resurrection.
Yeah, and this conversation is the reason the Lord has called us today.
I guess there's just a lot about this that I don't understand.
Well, we could help you understand if you want.
I think I would like that.
Thank you. Sevierville.
Thank you.
dignified. You need to understand, really, what Christmas is all about. You know, Rod kind of walked out, rejected the whole idea of Christmas. There are people that reject the idea of Christmas all the time. And right here in our midst, they may be in church, they may be singing Christmas carols, but they really don't understand the authenticity, the realness of the fact that Jesus Christ was born in a manger with a mission and a purpose to die on a cross so that you and I can have forgiveness of sin. The Bible says Christ came to save his people from their sin. It's my sin, your sin. Have you embraced it? I mean, really, do you know Christ as your Lord and as your Savior? Not are you identified with a religion, and not are you a church member, but do you know Jesus? Let's pray together. Father, I pray that our hearts will be very open and we'd understand the claims of Christ. Father, they're eternal. They're relevant. They're real. They speak to our hearts. God, for everybody that understands their hearts have an empty place in them, Jesus came to fill that empty place. Folks that really lack direction and purpose, Christ came to give them direction and purpose. Father, I pray that even tonight, in a great way, that a great message was presented, someone in this room would come to know Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name I pray. This is the invitation. Right where you are, how is it with your heart and with your life? You know, it's a matter between you and the Lord. Nobody else is involved. It's between you and Christ. If there's anyone here, as you look at your own life and you say, you know what, I really want to know Christ as my Savior. In just a moment, we're going to stand, the instrumentalists will play through a couple of verses of a hymn, and that'll be an indication for you to stand in the aisle, walk forward, and one of our pastors will be here just to pray with you. Only take a couple of minutes, but it can be life-changing in nature. Some of you who may be looking for a church home, we would invite you to come and unite with the First Family. This is the perfect place for imperfect people. This is a place for you to grow as a Christian. Everybody has a starting point, and then we continue to grow in the Lord. This is an equipping center to teach you how to live a victorious life in Christ. It's a place for your family to learn what it means to have a vibrant, growing relationship with Christ. Let's all stand together. If you make a decision for the Lord, you come. Ask our instrumentalists to play through a couple of verses. If you need to make a decision for Christ, you don't wait.